Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So in this video we will continue with the generator earth fault protection, stator earth fault protection. So basically it is going to be the second part of generator stator earth fault protections. Okay, that is why I have mentioned as 4b, as generator stator earth fault was released as part 4. Okay, so I am giving link in the I button and description so that you can check the first part where I described the generator earth fault protection by overcurrent, generator earth fault protection detection by overcurrent. Now in this video we will discuss about the detection of generator stator earth fault by over voltage and under voltage. So let's begin the video. So as you can see that this is the video for earth fault protection through over voltage. Okay, so first our scheme is residual over voltage protections. Here you can see the diagram. This is the generator, this is the generator neutral point, this is earth through an NGT, it may be a resistance earth. Okay, and this is the line PT. Okay, this is the PT. From here this is the secondary of the potential transformer. So from here the relay is taking 3 voltage input and their neutral point is connected to this point. So this is how this relay is receiving 3 phase voltages, and after receiving that it can internally calculate the residual voltage. Now when, how residual voltage will occur? In general when the system is running under normal condition, that is there is no fault, then all the phase voltage will be 120 degree apart, hence their summation will be 0. But when there is an earth fault, their summation will not be 0 anymore. So our target will be to detect the summation of the 3 phase voltages. So if we can detect the summation of the 3 phase voltage, if that is 0, that means there is no earth fault. But if that is not 0, that means there has been an earth fault. So here the voltage is not actually getting summing up, but the relay can internally calculate, internally sum up these phase voltages, internally sum up the voltage by this individual value of the phase voltages. Now if this scheme, don't consider these two connections, okay, this black dotted and the red line, don't consider this right now, I will explain it later. Now only focus on this connection. If this connection is made, you have to careful that this PT should be either 3 single phase PT unit or a 5 limb PT. Okay, because only using this PT, these two PTs, the zero sequence flux will be, residual flux will be flowed. Otherwise, if you use a 3-limb PT, there the residual flux will not be available. Okay, so for implementing this scheme, this first scheme, where the voltage, neutral voltage will be, or residual voltage will be calculated by the relay, you have to either select 3 single phase PT or a 5-limb 3-phase PT. Okay. Now the next possibility is to use a broken delta. See, this is a broken delta. Many people confuse it with open delta, but remember this is not open delta, this is called broken delta PT. Okay, here you can see that the 3 phase voltages are getting sum up. Okay. See that each of the phase voltage are getting sum up and it is getting fed to a relay coil. Okay. So here this relay is receiving some of the 3 phase voltages. Now one thing also you remember, that this PT winding rating should be 110/3, not the 110/√3. Suppose if this is an 11 kV generator, so you will using this PT, this phase voltage will be 11/√3 by 110/√3, but here this winding rating will be 110/3. Okay. So this is how you can also detect the residual over voltage. Here if the residual over voltage occurs, it will directly be fed to the relay. Now this relay is a over voltage type relay. See, I have written here V greater than. That means if you see that anywhere the relay is written as V greater than, you have to understand that that is an over voltage type relay. Okay. So this relay detects earth fault by over voltage. Now another scheme I have drawn here, that this is taking from the neutral, over voltage is taken from the neutral, that will be considered under neutral displacement protection. Okay, So let me elaborate this function. Okay, I hope you have understood these two functions. Now let me explain this function. So here you can see that this is the neutral displacement protection. So now if there is any earth fault, the earth fault current will pass through the neutral. Okay, so whatever resistance it faces in the neutral, it will create a voltage due to the IR. So that is the Ohm's law. So that voltage will be detected by this relay. So you can either tap it, if your generator is NGT grounded, you can directly tap it from here. Or if it is NGRR, then you have to place a voltage transformer here and you have to take the voltage to this over voltage relay. Or if the resistance is such that, or the generator is a very low voltage generator, you can also place directly, you can also place the relay directly, but it is not recommended. It is always better to place through a PT. Okay. So this is the neutral displacement protection by which you can detect the earth fault, seeing that how much voltage has appeared across the neutral. Okay. So now we will see the most important protection of the generator, that is 100% stator earth fault protection. So 100% stator earth fault protection is basically an under voltage protection. Okay. So see, this is the scheme for 100% stator earth fault protection. It is quite simple scheme. Now let me explain that how 100% earth fault is detected. Remember that generator always generates some third harmonic voltage to some degrees. Okay, now this third harmonic voltage measured at the neutral of the machine will drop for fault close to neutral. So if the fault has occurred away from the neutral point, the third harmonic voltage will be higher. If it is close to the neutral point, if it is somewhere here, the third harmonic voltage will be reduced. Now this connection, this arrangement will see the third harmonic voltage. This is the third harmonic under voltage relay. Okay, it will basically detect the third harmonic component of the voltage from the neutral point, and if it falls to a certain level, it actuates the relay and trips the circuit. So basically, by using the third harmonic under voltage protection and residual over voltage protection together, we can ensure the 100% earth fault protection. But remember that this third harmonic under voltage protection alone can take the fault occurs up to 30%. So by this you can ensure that your 100% stator winding has been protected. So I hope you have understood the techniques that how earth fault detection is, earth fault protection scheme is employed for a generator. I have not shown the relay setting methods here. I am only focusing on the circuit diagram right now. First you understand the circuit, then I will one by one explain the relay setting method. So hope you have enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Thank you very much for watching this video.